For me, my art, when I create these pieces, or what it was for me was
therapy. Which was?
Therapy. Yeah. I had this battling kidney disease on bone dialysis.
Which you were a nephrologist?
Yeah.
I've had so many people, you have no idea.
And as a way to help myself heal from that process, I mean, all the tubing and everything, I went to art. I have a lot of artist friends. I personally don't use paint, and I never thought what I could do to express myself, and there was paper. So in the process of creating these images, I'm always using or playing with the idea of life and start, of how I felt at the time when I was ill and mad and didn't have anybody to say anything to. It always came out in the paper.
And how long have you been tearing up paper and making it color?
14 years.
And here's what I want to encourage. Now, I'm just an art critic, so I can be wrong.
Right.
Because I don't make this stuff. I just attack everybody else's.
Okay.
I think you have a great way with material. I think you have to keep the material. I think there's a way to not only make abstractions for you, I think there's a way to make images. They might be machines, they might be diagrams, they might be shapes. But they don't all have to be what I would call a generic abstract. I think if you want to make the dialysis machine, maybe that's too far in the past, maybe that's too specific for you. There's a way you can do more than just tear up things and coat them with color. You can go all the way.
Well, actually, the paper that you see here is the color that you see.
Okay, so you're not coating
it. I'm not coating it.
You got blue paper,
right.
Yellow paper, red. Right. And what's this, the red and yellow?
It's a combination of what is going on with the paper.
Okay, these are great. He's inventing a way of painting. He's inventing a tool. And the tool is your fingers, and found papers and bought papers.
Right.
And I'm just suggesting that I am not great with abstraction. That's me, not you.
Right.
You're advanced that way, not me. I look at so many abstract paintings, I'm always wondering, they're all the same to me. They're like wallpaper to me.
Right.
So I'm just suggesting that you take control of the graphic field. And go for it. It doesn't mean a realistic figure of somebody like that at all.
Right.
It could just be a rectangle. I don't know what it could be, but the technique is great. Go for it. And I would also encourage you not to be bound by four sides.
Okay.
I think that if you're going to use cardboard and stuff, that these things can actually be bigger and shaped. Why? Because that would break out of the confinement. The graphic field that I'm feeling a pressure from
that
isn't making enough sense to me.
Right.
I think you could do this, and you've also invented a way to paint, which is one of the hardest things there is, and you did it naturally. You did it backwards.
Actually, at the beginning,
you did it backwards.
I used to cut and use a razor, and then I stopped that process and I started ripping.
So you went backwards.
Right.
Most people go have to figure out what they want to paint and how.
Right.
You now know how, and I'm trying to help you with what. I want your work to go like this.
Boom.
And elbow me. I want your work to sit on the wall and go. I want you to live in my bedroom. I want to sleep with you every night in your bedroom. That's what art is trying to do. As opposed to, don't I kind of look good? You know, that's not enough. All right. All right, good job. Do you need a picture? Come here.
Thanks, Steve.